starts doing the B section, second maybe.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brendan Gillen. Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. Je m'appelle Brendan Gillen. Au nom de l'Université McGill, je vous souhaite la bienvenue à la collation des grades de printemps 2019 de la Faculté des sciences de l'agriculture et de l'environnement. Let me welcome you on behalf of McGill University to the 2019 spring convocation for the Faculty of Agriculture and Environmental Sciences. We'll start in just a moment. Dans quelques instants, je vous soulignerai les étapes principales dans le déroulement de la cérémonie. In just a moment, I'll go over the principal steps in the ceremony, but first, let me invite you to join me in giving a very warm round of applause to the Brian Sand Quintet. Before I go over the details, two reminders. First, please don't stand on the chairs to take pictures. One thing is your own risk, but if you actually do injure yourself, that'll disrupt the entire ceremony. So please refrain from doing that. I understand the temptation. Secondly, this is my cell phone. This is an old cell phone. It's probably at least 5 or 6 years old. It has vibration mode. I assume most of you have more contemporary cell phones. Please put them on vibration mode. La cérémonie commencera avec l'entrée du cortège d'honneur et terminera avec son départ. À son entrée, je vous demanderai de vous lever. The ceremony will begin with the entrance of the platform party and end with its departure. Just before it enters, I'll ask you all to stand. Une fois le cortège d'honneur est installé sur la tribune, la Dr. Tracy Smith Bessette chantera l'hymne de l'université. Once the platform party members have found their places on stage, Dr. Tracy Smith Bessette will sing the university hymn. Wakila Gutzka, Louise McDonald Hearn, vous prononcera le mot de bienvenue de l'aîné. Wakila Gutzka, Louise McDonald Hearn, will say the elder's welcome, to begin with. Ensuite, le chancelier Michael Meehan, aussi bien que la principale Suzanne Fortier, vous adresseront chacun un bref discours suivi par l'allocution de Monsieur Charles Mouly, qui aura tout juste reçu un doctorat honoris causa. The principal Michael Meehan and the, I said that again this morning, the chancellor Michael Meehan and the principal, Suzanne Fortier, they haven't changed roles. Chacun will each say a few words, followed by the convocation address by Mr. Charles Mouly, who will have just received an honorary doctorate. Après la remise des diplômes, Monsieur Dennis Park fera le discours d'adieu. Once the diplomas have been conferred, Mr. Dennis Park will give the valediction. Ensuite, la secrétaire générale Edita Rogowska prononcera quelques remarques de clôture et la docteur Tracy Smith Bessette chantera l'hymne national. So after the valediction, the secretary general Edita Rogowska will say a few closing remarks and Dr. Tracy Smith Bessette will sing the national anthem. Le cortège d'honneur partira en premier, suivi par les diplômés, en commençant par l'avant et en passant vers l'arrière. The ceremony will end with the departure of the platform party, followed by the diploma recipients who will leave starting from the front and continuing to the back. J'invite maintenant le doyen des étudiants, Chris Buttle, à vous informer des mesures de sécurité mises en place dans l'éventualité très peu probable d'une urgence. I now invite the dean of students, Chris Buttle, to apprise you of the security precautions put in place in the very unlikely event of an emergency. Chris.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Not good enough. Good afternoon, everyone. Well done. Yes, I have the pleasure of sharing with you the emergency evacuation procedures. I expect good attention for this important matter. I also want to say congratulations to the graduating students. You've done all the hard work. The rest is up to us. You simply have to cross the stage. Congratulations to everyone. MAC Campus Ceremony is a special ceremony. You all know this is a special place, and as Dean of Students, I'm also a prof at MAC, so it's great to come home and see all of you here. If an evacuation is required, back to business, if an evacuation is required, the registrar will make such an announcement, and you'll be required to leave the building and evacuate to Watson Field, which many of you know. It's just outside of the Centennial Center. Follow the instructions of security officers and ushers. If you have babies with you, please leave baby strollers behind, but do not forget your children. If you need assistance, please speak to an usher or security officer. Si une évacuation des lieux devenait nécessaire, le registraire en ferait l'annonce. Vous devrez alors quitter le pavillon sans tarder et vous devrez vous rendre sur le terrain Watson. Suivez les instructions de placière et des agents de sécurité. Une fois la situation d'urgence passée, des annonces seront publiées sur le site mcgill.ca. Thank you for your attention. You did very well this afternoon. And welcome everyone once again.
Please stand. Levez-vous, s'il vous plaît.
Thank you, Dr. Tracy Smith-Bissett. Good afternoon, graduating students, families, and friends. As Chancellor, and on behalf of McGill University, I welcome you today to our beautiful McDonald campus to celebrate the class of 2019 and the students graduating from the Faculty of Agricultural and Environmental Sciences. Bon après-midi à tous les diplômés, proches et amis. À titre de chancelier, et au nom de l'Université McGill, je vous souhaite la bienvenue sur notre magnifique campus McDonald afin de célébrer la cérémonie de collation des grades 2019 et de souligner les réalisations des diplômés de la Faculté de l'Agriculture et de l'Environnement. Today we open the ceremony with a message of thanksgiving and greetings to the natural world. I invite Wargela Guts Day, Louise McDonald Hearn, a Bear Clan mother from the Akwesasne Mohawk Territory, to the podium. Mama Bear.
Sergo Zwagwego, Watkwanam Halado, Giogogo Skana Gantwas Wajatue, Tana Negijin, you got the last wheel, Gia Yatiga, Jinigaya Hundohutste, Ezwahun Quislo, Negit the Hundohutste, and Hodalona the Wheels to Hage. Tananegi and what the Kenholada, Greganahoda, Ne Yuki at the Genus, Naganta Unjagi, I don't want again. Ginola, you can't use Taha, Tanungwe, Sua, Genue, Yonu, Jitskalohia, Jitskalohia, the Genu Gadala Suyo, Jisegogi, Duatkatus, Tanasega, Ludio de Hagen, and a hodus, Seguayat, Diza Segunia, Sa, Toginaya, Tuhagen, Yoguanigula. Greetings. Welcome to this very momentous occasion. And I'm so honored and stand with great privilege to be invited by McGill to represent indigenous people of this land. So welcome to my home and native land. This is Mama Bear's house, and we gotta liven up this party. This morning was a little dry, so we gotta wake up here. But anyways, you know, I think it's really good that McGill is addressing indigenous people, original peoples of this land. And so I just wanna acknowledge how many indigenous students are in the graduating class. Raise your hand. McGill. We got some work to do. Okay, but you know, as we move along here, it's really a changing time in the world, and we represent a lot of diversity, especially in this country. And Canada itself, in its own infancy, when it was trying to name itself, used our Mohawk language. And 2019 is the year of Indigenous languages, and it called itself Canada, but we fondly refer to her as Ganada. And so this great country absolutely carries the power of our language within herself. And I also want to recall just last week, our beloved elder, Enoch Wazasne, passed away. He was 94 years old. His name was Levi Oakes, and he was a World War II veteran. And Mark Miller, who is the MP of Quebec, gave his eulogy there in Akwesasne. It was quite the funeral. All military personnel, including a U.S. Air Force flyby over our reserve to honor him. It was quite a huge event. But in the words of Mark Miller, he said, Levi was the last Mohawk code talker. There's none left. He used our Mohawk language during World War II. And Levi used secret code to protect his allies. No one ever broke the code talker's code. Levi served in the South Pacific, New Guinea, and the Philippines. My elder was awarded the Silver Star in the United States Congressional Silver Medal. And this elder saved my life when I was a young girl, 6 years old, from suffocating in an old refrigerator. One of those old fridges that you can open from the outside, but not from the inside. So luckily, he was there in a moment when, you know, it could have been a different story. So for more than 70 years, Levi kept the secret of what he had done. The story of Levi is an exceptional one and is an important reminder to the Grand Countries of Canada and the United States that when they needed First Nations people the most, we stood up. And the statistics bear this, as we know that Indigenous people had the highest rate of participation per capita in the world wars, including my own father. So Levi serves as a reminder that our Mohawk language is what saved our country, and he served it well. But unfortunately, when he returned home, his own children in this country were punished for speaking their language. So there's an incredible history in this country that needs to be acknowledged and righted. So in terms of truth and reconciliation, we need a lot to conciliate. But you know what? We're here to celebrate you guys and the hard work that you did to get here. And I don't want to, you know, take this party out. And, you know, I really want you to consciously be aware and know what you're stepping into. Because it's hard for me to stand here. Because even this week in Ottawa, the National Inquiry into Missing and Murdered Indigenous Woman was released. In Canada, admitting the hard truth about the devastating impacts of colonization, racism, and sexism, called it a national genocide, and it's ongoing today. So it's a miracle that you have an Indigenous woman standing in your company today. So graduates, party on. However, you face the harshest reality of any generation in history, I believe, because it's sobering that even the darkest days of World War I and II, which essentially assaulted human dignity, kindness, and common sense, that your future is almost unredeemable, almost hanging by a thread. The generation before you failed environmentally, politically, socially, morally, and spiritually. Our air and our water are threatened, not to mention that there are stockpiles of weapons that could destroy life on Earth in minutes. So what are we going to do about it? It's up to you, graduates. It really is up to you. You have to own your generation. So what are you going to leave behind? And I greatly apologize for my generation. I don't think we knew any better. But I'm letting you know now, you have an incredible chance at changing the world. I think there's a great poem that says, be the change you want to see in the world. And Mama Bear says, don't let the world change you. If you believe in something so greatly and you're so passionate about it, even though people tell you you're wrong, still do it anyways. So with that, I say party on, don't repeat history, learn from it, and to enjoy your achievement. You have earned it, and have a grand day, and thank you for this opportunity, Miguel. Yeah.
Thank you, Mama Bear. Let me begin by offering sincere congratulations to all graduates. C'est un grand jour pour vous, nos diplômés, et c'est un honneur pour moi d'être ici de partager avec vous cette étape importante. Now, I have a keen appreciation of the importance of this day and the memories you will keep with you for the rest of your life. Because once upon a time, when dinosaurs roamed the land, I was sitting in the audience as part of a graduating class from McGill, just like you. And I took much of the same journey as you have to arrive at this day. And some considerable time later, I returned on two occasions as the parent of McGill graduates. And like all parents here today, I was beaming with pride. Et maintenant, comme chancelier, j'ai le privilège d'assister à des cérémonies de collation des grades à chaque année. Vous pouvez donc dire que j'ai vu la remise des diplômes sous tous les angles. But whether as graduate or parent or chancellor, the occasion remains for me a richly deserved celebration of hard work, commitment, sacrifice, and above all, achievement. So bravo and well done to each and every one of you. Now, as chancellor, my job description includes making a speech to you today. It's a bit like writing an exam or making a class presentation. So I did what many of you may have done. I Googled best convocation speeches. And I got 575,000 results. But in the course of my research, I discovered that the best convocation speeches, I don't know why I've got conventions on the mind, usually contain three elements: a bit of humor at the beginning, a personal story or anecdote, and some practical advice that might be useful to graduates. I think I've already covered the humor part, at least I hope so, with the dinosaur line. So I'm going to move on to a personal anecdote or story. It's about my own grandfather, and although this story happened almost a century ago, I think it's still relevant to our world. His name was Arthur Meehan, and he served as the 9th Prime Minister of Canada. His main political opponent was Sir Wilfrid Laurier, and in the early 20th century, they were leaders of rival federal parties. As opposing political leaders, they sat opposite each other for more than a decade, and as you can imagine, they were fierce rivals. There were bitter debates and disagreements between them. So what did my grandfather have to say about Laurier? He said, and I quote, "There was never a man, not in my lifetime, from whom one could learn so much of the art of leadership as from Sir Wilfrid Laurier. One of the lamentations that I still indulge in is that I did not learn more from him. It's hard to imagine a statement like that coming from most of our political leaders today. For many today, the definition of leadership seems to have become associated with attributes we know only too well: shouting, name-calling, bullying, crass self-promotion, and belittling others in order to inflate one's own status. That seems to me to be a long way from what my grandfather described as the art of leadership. Now, at this point, you might be expecting me to launch into a nostalgic reverie about the good old days. And to be honest, sometimes I do tend to look in the rearview mirror. But that is until I see leaders of today like Jacinda Ardern, the Prime Minister of New Zealand, who showed such enormous courage and took such decisive action in the face of great tragedy and turmoil. Or Peter Bevan Baker, the leader of Prince Edward Island's Green Party and now the leader of the province's official opposition. He says he's interested in ideas, not just partisan politics, and his policies extend well beyond just environmental concerns. When we talk about leadership, we all automatically think about corporate leaders, political leaders, or high-profile personalities. But the real truth is that the art of leadership often begins with personal acts of conviction. I think Eric Molson, a former chancellor of Concordia University, put it well when he said, "If you want to be a leader, if you dream about changing the world and making it a better place, then it's your strong values that will be your beacon." And I really don't have to look very far to see some inspiring examples of that at our university. I think of Daniel Doran and Rudy Cabrera from McGill. They're both reservists in the armed forces, and both helped with relief efforts for Quebec communities devastated by the spring's flooding. I think of Milton Calderon Donifer and Sanjit Gupta, students and co-founders of a volunteer organization called Meal Care. Thanks to their efforts and a host of other McGill students, Meal Care diverts surplus food from cafeterias and other vendors at both the downtown and McDonald campuses that would otherwise go to waste, and instead donate the food to local homeless shelters and soup kitchens. But most of all, I think of you. I think of you, the graduates of 2019. You already have the unique education and experience that comes as being a graduate of McGill. You've distinguished yourselves in your own field of study. You've worked across disciplines and diverse areas. You're engaged, connected, and forthright, not just here on campus, but in the community. And most of all, you have the compassion, the conviction, and the courage to apply what you've learned here over the past years to the world we live in. Continuez donc à trouver des moyens d'inspirer les autres et de remettre en question le statu quo. Agissez en fonction de vos idées et de vos croyances. Écoutez les opinions divergentes et les avis différents. Aspirez à être des leaders, mais dirigez avec des esprits ouverts et des cœurs ouverts. Et restez en contact avec McGill et McDonald. Et revenez en tant que mentor auprès de la prochaine génération d'étudiants. Because wherever you go in the world, this will always be your home and will always cheer your successes and your accomplishments. Stay in touch, not just today, but throughout your journey as a McGill graduate and a true leader in your community, your country, and your world. I hope this day is both a joyous ending and an auspicious beginning for you all. Merci, bonne chance. It's now my pleasure to invite Professor Suzanne Feltier, Principal and Vice Chancellor of McGill, to address the audience. Professor Feltier.
Bienvenue à nos diplômés de 2019, excusez-moi. Je vous ai diplômé bien avant le temps. Hein? A warm welcome to the graduates of 2019. I'm really thrilled to be here today, joined by our chancellor, the chair of our board, Mama Bear, our distinguished honorary degree recipient, governors, special guests, and esteemed colleagues, and all your families and friends. Nous sommes réunis aujourd'hui pour vous dire à quel point nous sommes fiers de vous. We are so proud of you, our graduates of 2019. Félicitations, congratulations. As I was thinking about this day, one word came to mind, return. Now, you may find it a bit strange because you haven't left McGill or McDonald campus yet, but actually, I was thinking about the word return as it is used in the acronym ROI, Return on Investment. As you may know, it's an acronym that is used most often in the business world, and it usually is about financial investments and financial returns. That's not what I'm thinking about. I'm thinking about the personal investments we make and the return we get on our personal investments. And this is a great day for you to take a moment to reflect on your investments over the last several years here on McDonald campus. And as your name is called, as you walk across the stage, you should celebrate this very concrete return that you're receiving on your hard work, your resilience, and your perseverance. But this is just the beginning. The investment you've made, not only in your studies, but in creating long-lasting friendships, in collaborating with others, in having an impact on your community and contributing to it, or in excelling in activities outside of your formal studies, will have benefits for you throughout your life. Of course, you were not alone in investing here on your path to convocation. Many others have invested for your success. Your parents, your friends, professors, librarians, staff, all of the people who were there to support you and make sure that you would reach your goal. And so they too deserve a big round of applause. There's another kind of return that I'd like to talk about. It comes with an acronym also, ROL. I have to admit that I had no clue what it meant until I attended an MBA class at McGill. ROL stands for Return on Luck. Now, I think you know that life brings all of us unexpected turns, good and bad. Turns that are out of our control and beyond our grasp. We call it luck. What we do with our good luck, how we benefit from it, and more importantly, how we share it so that others benefit too, in many ways define the course of our lives and our impact on the world. Joanne Liu, who is president of Médecins Sans Frontières, Doctors Without Borders, expresses this concept in a very compelling way. Dr. Liu is a person who I think would say that she's had good luck. The good luck of being born in Canada, the good luck of being able to realize her dream of becoming a medical doctor. And she has shared her luck with others. As you know, Médecins Sans Frontières delivers medical care to people in danger, wherever they may be. And this is what Joanne said. I work with people who have no choice, and I believe we have to give them our best, precisely for this reason, because they have no choice. I don't pick, I don't take. I just give the best I can. And finally, another acronym that I want to share with you. This one, I made it up, inspired by my class in the MBA program. I called it ROR, Return on Respect. I know it may not always be obvious, but I believe it always pays off immensely to show respect to all of those around us. And as we move forward, I think it is important for all of us to know, to understand that every human being deserves respect and that all of us should give respect to all people around us. Et donc, j'espère qu'en quittant McGill, vous vous souviendrez de tout ce que vous avez appris ici et que vous le mettrez à l'œuvre afin de façonner un monde meilleur, non seulement pour vous, mais pour la planète tout entière. Today, you join the global network of McGill alumni, a network of people who have made immense contributions to society. And as we prepare to celebrate our 200th anniversary, let's dream together about what we'll do in our third century. So please, do return to your alma mater. Congratulations, félicitations.
Thank you, Professor Fortier. We'll now proceed with the award presentation. I invite Professor Jim Files to present this year's winner of the McDonald Campus Award for Teaching Excellence. And I invite the winner to please stand when their name is called and to join the principal at center stage. Professor Files.
Thank you. Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you Professor and Associate Dean Ian Strachan. Professor Strachan is an associate professor in the Department of Natural Resource Sciences and cross-appointed to the Department of Geography. Dr. Strachan has an unusual set of teaching responsibilities, regularly teaching on both campuses. His courses include meteorology on the McDonald campus, climatic environments downtown, and environment and health, which is taught on both campuses in collaboration with Nancy Ross from the Department of Geography. Most students have no background in meteorology or climate when they enter Professor Strachan's classes, so building from the fundamentals is essential. As one student wrote, "By the final exam, I realized just how much material we had covered and how everything came together so nicely. We started off with simple gas laws, and by the end, we're able to describe very complex weather systems." Professor Strachan's lectures are interactive and engaging, focused around demonstrations, student presentations, and discussion to explore difficult concepts. In the words of his students, he is super responsive to student questions, obviously extremely caring about the subject and his students. Another wrote, "I think Ian Strachan was born to be a teacher. His passion was transparent." And another wrote, "Kept us awake at 8:30. - loved going to class, even at 8:30. But the last one is even more poignant. "We respect him for his knowledge and instruction. We adore him for his friendliness, sense of humor, and care." Madam Vice Chancellor, it is with appreciation and pride that we present Ian Strachan, this year's winner of the McDonald Campus Award for Teaching Excellence.
Congratulations, Professor Strachan, on your great accomplishment. L'Université McGill est ravie de célébrer les réalisations de Monsieur Charles Mouly. I ask Professor Anya Geitman, Dean of the Faculty of Agricultural and Environmental Sciences, to present our distinguished guest so that he may have conferred upon him the highest recognition that it is within the power of this university to grant, and ask Mr. Moley to join me at center stage for the presentation of the honorary degree.
Let me start with a welcome to family and friends to McDonald Campus. McDonald Campus, that is the place of people who are really, really passionate, such as our professor, Dr. Strachan, as well as, of course, the students who have spent their last years here. I'm here now to present the most recent graduate of this campus who only discovered it and visited it for the first time today. Mr. Chancellor, I present to you Charles Moley, a symbol of hope for marginalized communities and impoverished and orphaned children, having overcome a difficult childhood himself. Born in Kangundo, Kenya, in 1949, Charles Moley was abandoned by his family at 6 years old and spent his adolescence begging on the streets. With only an eighth grade education, Charles Moley toiled as a child laborer at a coffee bean plantation. He eventually secured a job working for a large company in Nairobi, which he parlayed into his own taxi business. Beginning with one taxi, Mr. Moley expanded his company to a fleet of taxis, then a bus company, and a transport company, eventually culminating in an insurance company. While on business in Nairobi in 1986, Charles Moley experienced a life-changing incident. Approached by a group of street children while exiting his car, he refused to give them any money. This refusal stemmed from his belief that doing so would encourage the purchase of illegal substances. Returning a few hours later, Mr. Moley realized that his car had been stolen. It was not the material loss that stuck with Charles Moley, but rather the desperation of the children, a situation he could well understand. The memory of those street children remained with Mr. Moley for the next 3 years until he decided to sell his lucrative business in order to take care of those lost souls. Charles Moley et sa femme Esther ont alors fondé en 1989 Moley Children's Family, MCF, dont le nom provient du nom de la famille. Il s'agit d'un organisme de bienfaisance qui supervise diverses interventions, allant de la protection des enfants à l'éducation et aux soins de la santé et de la sécurité alimentaire et l'agriculture à la responsabilisation sociale et économique. Par ailleurs, les pépinières de MCF transplantent plus d'un million d'arbres chaque année, atténuant les effets du réchauffement climatique par la réapparition d'un microclimat. Cette initiative a permis à MCF de stocker des millions de litres d'eau, rendant possible la culture de terres arides. At its inception, the Moley family home became a refuge for nearly 100 orphans of various different tribes. Today, the organization cares for 3,500 children in 7 facilities within Kenya, while simultaneously building the capacity of various projects across Africa to emulate the Moley model. Using Charles Moley's life story of sacrifice and giving, director Scott Hayes released a documentary entitled Moley, winning several international awards and providing a different perspective to millions globally. Charles Moley has won numerous awards for his philanthropic efforts, for his exemplary work in humanitarian and Christian service to the less fortunate. Mr. Moley was awarded the Robert W. Pierce Award in 1999 by World Vision International. The Canadian branch of World Vision awarded Charles and his wife Esther the Angel of Hope Award in 2002. The Kenyan Minister for Finance awarded Mr. Moley the Jubilee Insurance Company Samaritans Award in 2007. And in 2009, the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Kenya awarded Charles Moley the Head of State's Commendation. Mr. Chancellor, I present to you Charles Moley so that you may confer upon him the degree of Doctor of Science, honoris causa.
Now it gives me great pleasure to invite McGill's most recent graduate to address convocation, Dr. Moley.
Good afternoon. Chancellor Megan, Principal and Vice Chancellor Fortier, Mr. Panda, Chair of the Board of Governors, proud families and guests, and most of all, members of the graduating class of 2019. I may not fully express to you how I am gratefully humbled to join the McGill University fraternity today here in Montreal, Canada, to receive this prestigious degree of a Doctor of Science Honoris Causa. I am deeply moved by this recognition and sincerely thank the University Senate for the nomination and subsequent award. Allow me to dedicate this special moment of my life to God, who is the author and the foundation of MCF, Moley Children's Family. My beloved wife, Esther, who is here with me, who has stood by me over the years. My biological family, who believed in me. The 3,500 children under my care today, and over 15,000 children and youth who have successfully been rehabilitated. Through Moley Children's Family, their hopes and dreams restored and their lives transformed to become resourceful citizens and servants, not only in Kenya, Africa, but in different continents across the world. I have committed my life to see destitute children and marginalized populations lead dignified livelihood through rescue and rehabilitation, provision of food, water, as well as the most fundamental need of education for every destitute child, regardless of where they come from. Joining the role of honor of this celebrated university here in Canada and the world that is accredited for producing dynamic leaders in diverse fields is indeed a higher calling to me. As a steward, this recognition inspires scaling up innovativeness in our humanitarian programs to realize the vision of seeing the children and the marginalized population in our society lead dignified livelihoods. To all graduates assembled here today, during this spring convocation 2019, please receive my warm congratulations for your achievement. This day marks a moment of completion and a celebration of an important academic stage in your lifetime. As a parent, or as parents and guardians of thousands of children and youth, I know this is a special day as we do not only celebrate your academic achievement, but also celebrate your parents and the proud families, the entire McGill University community, as well as your guardians who have given you a conducive social environment to thrive and receive the best education. The stage you are leaping over today has provided you with knowledge and skills, enhancing your abilities, gifts, and capacity to pursue your careers. The competitive and dynamic world needs more than knowledge and skills. It also needs innovative minds and wisdom to be able to navigate through attendant challenges and risk in all occupations. Surround yourself with the right people as you desist all distractions from your career path. Be humble and seek mentors to support your career progression. As a citizen of the world, may I also remind you to be dependable stewards of the skills and the knowledge you have acquired, and that whatever you choose to do with them, let it be in service to the world to promote equity, peace, and health environment for the survival of human race. I have no doubt that the graduating class of 2019 gives Canada and the world a blessed generation, a generation of professionals ready to positively impact the lives of people and communities they will work with or even serve. I wish you all the most success beyond your imagination as you pursue diverse career paths. As citizens of the world, our responsibility to the environment must be taken up with urgency by investing in climate change, which I believe so much, and at the place where we live in Kenya. The Climate Change Mitigation and Adaptation Initiative to safeguard future generations. Having planted over 5.8 million trees within Muli Children family and constructed dams for conserving water, as well as successfully farmed in semi-arid lands, this is proof that we can secure enough food production by mastering our environment. Famine and starvation infringe on human rights. A starving person metamorphoses to a beggar who has no say to what they are given. This, in turn, leads to infringement of their fundamental rights. Therefore, we should seek to have partnership and a collaboration to infer technology that seeks to improve both the production and the distribution of food to famine-prone areas in our nations. My appeal to you today and to all people of the world in different professions and ventures is to value being important in the life of another. There is value in supporting each other, including the needy in society, because it is inspiring. It is service to God, and it advances unconditional love and a peaceful coexistence. You cannot get gold out of nowhere. And this is my saying, you must dig and work for it through a vigorous process. Thank you so much, and may God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Molly, for a most inspiring and thoughtful address. We are in awe of what you have done for those who are among the most vulnerable in our society, and we welcome you into our McGill community. Nous allons maintenant procéder avec l'attribution des grades universitaires. Professor Christopher Manfredi, Provost and Vice Chancellor, will begin the formal proceedings. Professor Romney.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. I am pleased to invite students graduating from the Faculty of Agricultural and Environmental Sciences for the conferral of degrees. This is a truly joyous event in the cycle of the university's life, particularly at McGill, where we have such talented and accomplished students. Each student crossing the stage will be greeted by the chancellor, the principal, or the chair of the Board of Governors. Students receiving their first degree shall remove their mortarboard or hat. At center stage, they will be symbolically capped, signaling ceremonially the conferral of the degree. Students who have already earned a university degree keep their mortarboards on and will be congratulated by a tap on the shoulder. The parchment or degree itself is given to students after they have a photo taken and leave the stage. At many of our convocations, you will see students wearing red or white scarves. All self-identifying Indigenous students, First Nations, Inuit, and Métis, are entitled to wear graduation scarves at convocation, in the community, and at any and all future McGill events that they attend. The red scarf is for those receiving a degree, and white for those getting a diploma or certificate. The feather has two meanings, respect for the person, and the mark of an amazing or special event. The Confederacy belt signifies attachment to and respect for the land on which we live, and the turtle symbolizes the inclusiveness of all nations and respect for diversity. It is fitting that we recognize our Indigenous graduates in this way, just as we recognize that McGill University's campuses are on land which long served as a site of meeting and exchange amongst Indigenous peoples, including the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe Nations. We acknowledge and thank the diverse Indigenous people whose presence has enriched this territory on which peoples of the world now gather. En vertu des pouvoirs qui me sont conférés par le Sénat de McGill, je déclare que les candidats dont le nom figure sur la liste officielle des diplômés de l'université, qu'ils soient présents ou absents, ont satisfait aux exigences de leur grade, diplôme ou certificat respectif. By virtue of the powers conferred upon me by McGill Senate, I declare that the candidates whose names appear on the university's official list of graduates, whether they be present or absent, have satisfied the requirements for their respective degrees, diplomas, or certificates. By tradition at McGill, we begin with students receiving graduate degrees, followed by students obtaining undergraduate degrees. I now invite Professor Ian Strachan, followed by Professor Jim Files, to present the graduates, and Professor Anya Geit, Faculty of Agricultural and Environmental Sciences, to congratulate all graduating students. Congratulations, class of 2019. Félicitations.
For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy and Entomology, Sean Turney. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy and Microbiology, Janina Altschuler. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Parasitology, Anwar Kotaram Patel. Najme Nikpur. For the degree Doctor of Philosophy in Plant Science, Maxime Lefebvre. Christiana Lovett. For the degree Doctor of Philosophy in Renewable Resources, Matthew Burke. Jacob Ziegler. For the degree of Master of Science in Animal Science, Deanna Figueroa Delgado. Stephanie LaForce. Jessica St. John. For the degree of Master of Science in Entomology, Marie-Ève Chagnon. Congratulations. Jessica Turgeon. For the degree of Master of Science in Microbiology, Jinglin Chen. For the degree of Master of Science in Plant Science, Christine Cameron. For the degree of Master of Science in Renewable Resources, Esteban Gongoria Bernoski. Emery Hartley. Xuan Shang. For the degree of Master of Science Applied in Biotechnology, Sai Akikwari. Maria Aguirre-Franco. Nyandio Ambercar. Just one time. Okay. Apinder Kaur. Amandeep Dhillon. Chrisanne D'Souza. Anna Huang. Aksha Kadri. Timothy Liao. Atlanta Bajumdar Barman. Brittany Pounder. Ilma Rahman. Ritu Rantawa. Delia Saldana. Iqbaljeet Santu. Anshu Saran. Irina Segovia. Shruti Sharma. Akshaya Srikanth. Lisa Walker. Tianxiao Yang.
For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agricultural and Environmental Sciences in Agricultural Economics, Lingyi Chun. Tian Tian Li. Nicolas Martel Bouchard. Rowan Mollett. for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agricultural and Environmental Sciences in Agro-Environmental Sciences, Virginie Bernier, Dean's Honor List. Conan Fidahusen. Jonathan Francoul. Thomas Giguère, Distinction. Andrienne LaSalle. Sasha McIntosh Hobson, Dean's Honor List. Camille Pion. Sandrine Saint-Pierre Lepage, Jerry Fryer's Undergraduate Research Award, Convocation Award, Dean's Honor List. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agricultural and Environmental Sciences in Environment, Catherine Camille Choquette, Distinction. Barker William Colbert Reagan. Tania Couture. Connor Nicolas DeSantis, Honors in Environment. Ren Ariel Stewart Donnestad. Catherine Fredette. Philippe Grenier, First Class Honors in Environment, Dean's Honor List. Mathilde Isabelle Odette Guglielmi, Honors in Environment. Michael Thomas Hole. Jean-Lou Lee. Luke Andreas Malcolm. Camille Marie Clementine Mancion. Catherine Anne Mardakis. Laura Peña Silva. Nicholas David Pfeiffer Major. Anaïs Poitras. Wu-Yu Sun. Tavernese. Gabriella Tavernese. Tia Tong. Audrey Constance Wagner, Distinction, First Class Honors in Environment. Tichen Wang, First Class Honors in Environment. Naomi Weinberg, Distinction, First Class Honors in Environment. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agriculture and Environmental Sciences in Environmental Biology, Zoe Amelia Bonerbo. Samuel Colin Latour, First Class Honors in Environmental Biology. Agathe Sundari Santi Gervais. Béatrice Gervais Bergeron, Distinction. Yeah. Mercy Earl Harris, First Class Honors in Environmental Biology, Ping Quan Lau Convocation Prize, Dean's Honor List. Ella Martin, First Class Honors in Environmental Biology, Dean's Honor List. Karen Ono. Michael Adam Palaskas, Honors in Environmental Biology. Gabrielle Leah Remock, Distinction, First Class Honors in Environmental Biology. Noemi Hua, First Class Honors in Environmental Biology, Dean's Honor List. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agricultural and Environmental Sciences in Global Food Security, Neela McLeod Farley, Distinction. Clementine Matisco, Distinction. Rebecca Sarah Seltzer, Distinction. Yirong Zhang. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Agricultural and Environmental Sciences in Life Sciences, Biology and Agriculture. Natasha Berghuis, Distinction. Shuk Ting Chan. Wing Chi Chun, Dean's Honor List. Chantal Coutu. Bailey Maria Daghofer Hawes. Huixuan Jia. Emily Kretschmann. Julian Leung. Yeah. Shannon Grace Manley, Honors in Life Sciences. Vincent McCarty, First Class Honors in Life Sciences, Dean's Honor List. Serena Moore, Distinction, First Class Honors in Life Sciences. Jason Scott Ninnis. Dennis Park, Dean's Honor List. Haley Pelland, Distinction. Elise Perrault, Dean's Honor List. Romeo Praretti. Coralie Raymond, First Class Honors in Life Sciences. Maisie Roach Krajewski. Emma Nancy Dale Rollins, Honors in Life Sciences. Philip Isaac Rosenbaum, Dean's Honor List. Elizabeth Alexandra Siciliani, Distinction, First Class Honors in Life Sciences. Xinxin Chu. For the Farm Management and Technology Program, Pierre-Alexandre Beaulieu. Etienne Bouchard-Quinn. Eric Brooks. Anthony Charles Côté, Governor General's Collegiate Bronze Medal, Médaille d'Or du Ministère d'Agriculture, des Pêcheries et d'Alimentation du Québec, Dean's Honor List. Alex Pascal Domen. Matthew Hunter Elliott. Noel George Erskine. Philip Gauthier. Frank Harrell. Kimberly Ann Jacobs. Wyatt Johnson. Remy Mayu. Jonas Arthur Marcus Morrison. Lachlan Daniel John McDonald. Stephen Raymond Moran. Sandra Ann Parisino. Jessica Rouleau. Ophelia Sarakinis, Dean's Honor List. Devin Steiner. Alexandre Verdonk. Maggie Villeneuve.
Thank you, Professors Files and Strachan, for doing such a wonderful job in reading the graduates' names. I now invite Mr. Dennis Park to say a few words on behalf of all graduating students as this year's valedictorian. Mr. Park.
Mr. Chancellor, members of the platform party, and fellow graduates and guests, I'm honored to be standing before you as the 2019 valedictorian. Thank you. Thank you. So graduating is a big accomplishment, one that we have been looking forward to since the beginning of our academic career. But now that we are finally here, it feels surreal. Yet for many of us, this is just the beginning of the next chapter of our lives. From this moment on, we open the doors to society and walk into the world as proud graduates of McGill University. Whether it's working at a multinational firm, attending lab meetings at our company, or moving on to graduate studies, we all carry the spirit of McGill on our backs. And as graduates of McGill, our actions should send a clear message to the world that says no matter our sex, color, or culture, anyone can succeed with equal opportunity and achieve their wildest dreams with enough effort and willpower. Just like our academic journey here at McGill, life is equally filled with uncertainties and challenges. But let us follow the courage in our hearts and set an example for all those that follow in our footsteps and to those who will look up to us as future leaders. If you feel that life is becoming too overwhelming, remember, no matter how difficult life may become, you always have the choice to view these challenges as opportunities and approach them with optimism. Class of 2019, you hold the power to change the world, and each and every one of you possesses the knowledge, wisdom, and capability to do so. Good luck, fellow graduates. Do persevere and do not give up, for there will be greatness waiting for us in the end. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Park. Will the graduating class please stand? Je demande à tous les diplômés de se lever. À titre de chancelier de l'Université McGill, je déclare et confirme que chacun de vous a maintenant le droit à la distinction de grade, diplôme ou certificat qui vous a été conféré, avec tous les honneurs, droits, privilèges et responsabilités qui y sont rattachés. In my capacity as Chancellor of McGill University, I declare and confirm that each of you is now entitled to the distinction of the degree, diploma, or certificate that has been conferred upon you, with all the honors, rights, privileges, and responsibilities that are pertinent thereto. Félicitations, congratulations. Secretary General, Ms. Edith Rogowska, will now make a few closing remarks.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. In closing, I'd like to leave you with a few words from the late Stanley B. Frost, McGill professor, administrator, and historian, who in his work on the history of McGill says the following. Traditions are hard to come by, but once established, they are remarkably enduring. The university has been fortunate that the tradition was early established, that McGill is not merely an institution, but a community in which bonds of affection are strongly woven so that a sense of belonging need not end with graduation, but can be a lifelong experience. J'espère que les liens d'amitié que vous avez tissés à McGill seront avec vous longtemps et feront partie de ce que vous allez faire, tant au niveau personnel que professionnel, que ce soit ici, au Canada ou ailleurs dans le monde. En vous souhaitant le meilleur des succès, je vous dis bonne chance et bonne continuation. Félicitations.
To conclude the ceremony, please stand and join Dr. Tracy Smith-Bassett in the singing of our national anthem.